Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dr. T. Uttara Falguni, Assistant Professor of Botany, Government Degree College, Shadnagar. Today, we are going to study about general characters of cyanobacteria, which is a syllabus for first sem students. Cyanobacteria, which is also known as blue-green algae, are oxygenic phototrophic bacteria. They show similarities to bacteria and also algae. They use the oxygenic they are called as oxygenic phototrophic bacteria that use water as an electron donor in photosynthesis, during photosynthesis, and they give up the oxygen. They show similarities between similarities to bacteria and algae. These show similarities with bacteria by including the both the groups include unicellular and colonial forms. Cells are covered by gelatinous and mucilaginous sheath. The cell walls possess murine and diamino pimelic acid. And both the cells, bacteria and the cyanobacteria, both are prokaryotic. They lack cell organelles, membrane bound cell organelles. And in both the organisms, ribosomes are of 70S type, and the lamellosomes of blue-green algae seem to be morphologically similar to that of the mesosomes of bacteria. And both organisms lack sexual reproduction. And they even show similarities with algae. And the blue-green algae are invariably aflagellate, whereas many bacteria are flagellate. And the blue-green algae are photosynthetic and use chlorophyll A to capture light energy, whereas only a few bacteria are photosynthetic, but they lack chlorophyll A. And during photosynthesis, blue-green algae use water as a source of hydrogen, whereas bacteria use H2S hydrogen or other inorganic compounds. Blue-green algae are aerobic, whereas many bacteria are anaerobic. And let us see the occurrence of the cyanobacteria or cyanophysi members. They are widely distributed in freshwater, marine, terrestrial habitats. Most of these are tropically distributed, tropically in habitat. Most of them are freshwater forms like Dermocarpa, Trichodesmium. They are marine, and they also occur as phytoplanktons. They form blooms in water bodies. They live as epiphytes, and they also live as benthic formation on mud. Some grow as endophytes, like for example nostoc and Mosellatoria. They grow as endophytes in roots of cycas, leaves of rhizola, and also in anthoceros, in thallus of anthoceros. And some species are the phycobiont of lichens. Lichens, which is a symbiotic association of fungi and algae. These species, some of the cyanobacteria species, they form the phycobiont of the lichens. For example, Cytonema, Nastoc, Leocapsa, and all that. They form the algal component of the lichens. And some form the planktons in organically rich permanent waters. Organically rich permanent water bodies, they form the planktons. The polluted waters, they are rich in cyanophysian members. Next, let us see the organization of thallus. It ranges from unicellular non-motile forms, colonial, multicellular, unbranched, filamentous forms, and filamentous forms with false branching, to highly evolved heterotrichous forms with the true branching. Here you can see Chloroporphyrus, which is a unicellular non-motile form, and in the Geocapsa, it is a colonial form, and multicellular unbranched filamentous forms. For example, Oscillatoria, unbranched multicellular forms, and Cytonema, which shows false branching, filamentous form and showing false branching. And highly evolved heterotrichous forms with the true branching are seen in Stygonema. So various types of organization of thallus are seen in various variety of organization of thallus is seen in Cyanophysian members. Let us see the cell structure. Here, cell structure like bacteria, the cells of cyanobacteria also have prokaryotic cell structure organization. The cell is devoid of organized nucleus, chromatophores, mitochondria, and other cell organelles. So this cell structure, cell wall is surrounded by a mucilaginous sheath. Mucilaginous sheath is present constantly. It is a constant feature of the cyanobacteria. The sheath consists of mainly three layers of microfibrils, which are reticulately arranged within an amorphous matrix. This mucilage is rich in glucose, xylose, mannose, and galactose. In some cases, it even contains the uronic acid. The mucilage sheath retains absorbed water, which is useful during the periods of desiccation. So, during when water is not available, when during the formation of desiccation, it retains water and helps the organism. So, cyanobacteria, previously they were even also called as Mixophysian members due to the presence of this slime mucilaginous sheath. As a mixophysi, they are the slime plants. They are called as slime plants. And then inner to the mucilaginous sheath, cell wall is present. A double-layered cell wall is present inside the mucilaginous sheath, and it corresponds to that of the gram-negative bacteria. Then all the layers are interconnected. These layers of the cell wall are interconnected by plasmodesmata. Numerous pores are also present on cell wall, which acts as passages for secretion of slime by the cell. Then inner to the cell wall, plasma membrane is present. Plasma membrane, a cytoplasmic membrane, consists of two electron opaque layers separated by a slight translucent layer. Cytoplasm encloses the cytoplasm and other inclusions. Then inner to the plasma membrane, cytoplasm is present. Cytoplasm is distinguished into two regions. The outer peripheral region, which is called as chromoplasm, and the inner part, which is called as a centroplasm, which is a colorless region, central colorless region, which is known as centroplasm. So let us see the chromoplasm. It contains flattened vesicular structures, which is called as a photosynthetic lamellae. They are also called as thylakoids. These thylakoids, they may be peripheral, parallel, or central in position. They are not separated from the cytoplasm by a membrane-bound structure. They appear elongated. They are the flattened sacs, consists of two unit membranes. Each is about 35 angstrom thickness, and adjacent to the thylakoids, adjacent thylakoids are separated. For each adjacent thylakoids, they are separated by a space of 50 nanometers. Here you can see the thylakoids. And chromoplasm, even the photosynthetic pigments are present. C-phycocyanin, C-phycoerythrin, and several photosynthetic pigments such as chlorophyll A, chlorophyll C, carotenoids, xanthophylls are also present inside this lamella. Okay, photosynthetic lamella. Then centrally, there is a nucleoplasm. The central region of cyanobacteria cell appears somewhat transparent, and it contains the genetic material. An organized nucleus and a nuclear membrane, they are absent in the cyanophysian members. Genetic material consists of just DNA fibrils, and they are not associated with histones, that is protein material. RNA is also present in addition to the DNA. Then all the cytoplasmic inclusions include Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, and the mitochondria. There are various kinds of granules like cyanophysian granules, polyhedral bodies, and structural granules which are present in this, which include the cytoplasmic inclusions, which are present in this cytoplasm. Then they can, beside these granules, ribosomes and gas vacuoles are also present. As it is a prokaryotic cell structure, it is having prokaryotic cell structure. It consists of 70S type of ribosomes. The gas vacuoles are visible in planktonic blue-green algae and are useful in floating. So these cyanophysian members show prokaryotic cell structure. They lack the membrane-bound cell organelles, and these cell wall is surrounded by a thick mucilaginous sheath. This mucilaginous sheath helps the cell during desiccation. It retains water holding capacity during desiccation, and all the membrane-bound cell organelles are present. DNA is present in the form of fibrils, lacking a definite nuclear membrane. And next is the moments. In cyanobacteria, flagella are absent. So some filamentous forms, they exhibit the gliding moment. Next, let us see the reproduction. Cyanobacteria reproduce only by vegetative and asexual methods. There is no sexual reproduction in cyanobacteria. Vegetative reproduction in the cyanobacterial cells is done by cell division. So in, for example, in crococcales, example we have taken as Crococcus species, here the only method of reproduction is cell division. After cell division, the daughter cell may remain in a common gelatinous sheath. During fission, the algal cell divides by the formation of a septum. You can see the cell division stage also here. A septum is formed from periphery to the center, thus dividing the cell into two daughter cells. Nuclear material also divides simultaneously without undergoing any stages of division. So cell division in Crococcales is, reproduction in Crococcales is only done by the cell division. Next comes the fragmentation. Fragmentation, sometimes in colonial non-filamentous algae, repeated cell division results in an extremely large colony, okay, or a trichome of unlimited size. So that leads to the fragmentation. Sometimes it leads to the fragmentation. Thus, it results into two or more individuals. Here you can see the microcystis. After forming a large colony, it is fragmented and it is separated. It leads as a separate bacterial colony, cyanobacterial colony. Okay. Next, hormogonia. These are chiefly produced in the order Nostocales. For example, Nostoc. Okay, or you can see even in the oscillatory example. In the order Nostocales and Stigonometales, these species fragmentation of takes place here. Fragmentation of trichome takes place by the formation of hormogonia. Here you can see the hormogonia. So the hormogonia are the short naked filaments of trichome with both rounded ends. Here you have the both the rounded ends. They get separated from the parent element and they leave as a separate individual filament. So these disabsorb water and it results in the separation between the main filament and the hormogonia. Separation discs are formed. The discs of gelatinous material are formed as a result of the death of the certain cells. So after this, this hormogonia is separated from the parent cell and lays as a separate cell. Okay. Next, asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is done by echinates, endospores, and echinates. For example, we have taken the Nostoc. Echinates, these are the very thick-walled, resistant spores, or they can be also called as resting spores. These spores, they are meant to tide over unfavorable conditions. During unfavorable environmental conditions, few of the cells in the filament, they enlarge, they accumulate food materials, and they become yellow or dark brown in color. They form the echinates. They become thick-walled and change into spherical perinating structures. Few of the cells during unfavorable environmental conditions. They form, they enlarge in size, they store, accumulate food materials, and they become yellow or dark brown in color, and they form the aconites or spores. The aconites possess cyanophycian granules, hence that's why they appear as brown in color. So under the favorable conditions, these aconites germinate into vegetative filaments and form into the normal cyanophycian filaments. So next to that, endospores. Another form of asexual reproduction, these non-filamentous cyanobacteria generally produce endospores, exospores, and nanocytes. Mostly endospores are present. These endospores are small spores formed endogenously within a cell. Here you can see in Dermocarpa, many cells, many endospores have formed. Endospores are small spores. They are forming endogenously within a cell. During endospore formation, cytoplasm of the cell is cleaved into several small bits, and they get converted into a number of endospores. Initially, these endospores will be naked, but on liberation, they secrete a small thin wall around them. Without undergoing any period of rest, the spore germinates into a new plant body. For example, Dermocarpa. Here the cytoplasm have divided into tiny bits, and each form an endospore, and later on it develops a thin cell wall like material, thin wall. Then afterwards, after the liberation of these spores, immediately they germinate. They won't undergo any resting period like echinids. Then the heterosis. Heterosis, for example, they are seen in Oscillatoria nostra. Heterosis, they are the modified vegetative cells. These are the heterosis cells. Depending on nitrogen concentration in the environment, heterocyst formation occurs. Heterocysts are slightly enlarged cells. They are slightly pale yellow in color, contain an additional outer covering. Heterocysts, they contain an additional outer covering. They, depending upon the nitrogen concentration in the environment, the heterocyst formation occurs. They are the thick-walled cells. They are pale yellow in color, barrel-shaped structures. The outer layer is fibrous and middle homogeneous, and inner layer is lamellar in nature. The wall layers become thicker at the polar regions here, and they form the pores are plugged with the refractive material, which are called as the polar granules. These heterocysts, they help in nitrogen fixation. These heterocysts of an cyanophycian, they are the cyanophycian members. They are formed in cyanophycian members. The heterocysts are simply dead cells. Previously they thought that they are dead cells and they don't have any function, but later on, heterocysts, in the presence of heterocysts, makes a trichome weak and it breaks its point. Thus, they are the points of breakage of filaments in the fragments. These heterocysts, consists of heterocysts, okay, previously they thought that heterocysts, they doesn't have any function, but later on they found that they stimulate the production of the echinids, and they also found out that most of the cyanobacteria which fix atmospheric nitrogen, they contain the heterocyst. So later on most of the factors inhibiting nitrogenous enzymes system also inhibit the formation of heterocysts. So that's why they found that heterocysts are the main sites of the nitrogen fixation in bacteria. So these are the main general characters of cyanophycian members.